And by the way, here's what they wanted, really. They were looking for retaliation. Yes. That's the reason they wanted him to be a king. That's the reason they wanted him on a horse. Because they wanted to get those Romans. They wanted to get those Romans. They wanted Jesus to come in and just wipe them out with the sword. They wanted retaliation. Let me ask you a question. Do you think you've got some enemies? Somebody ought to say absolutely. What do you want to do with them? I mean, I'm only raising this question because the folk in this text, they wanted revenge. They wanted retaliation. They wanted Jesus to take care of their enemies. They were different than us, I'm sure. They're different than us. We don't say, that's all right, I'm just going to tell the Lord about it. I'm going to put the Lord on them. We don't do that. We love our enemies. We pray for them. Matter of fact, this morning when we got up, before we got out of bed, we rolled on our knees and we said, Lord, bless my enemies. Bless the people who causing me trouble. You're a liar. You're a liar. And so there is a sense in which there are some similarities between those people 2,000 years ago and us people here in Greater Exodus. I'm trying to draw a correlation. It's very important that we get this. Because, you see, now let me explain to you what they didn't understand. Now, they didn't understand this, that Jesus was not going to kill the enemies. Jesus wanted to save their enemy. Somebody lost me. So if Jesus wanted to save their enemies, what do you think he wanted to do to your enemies? Oh, you hear what I'm saying? And so Jesus is not in the business of, you pull out a genie and a bear comes out and whack your enemies. No, he's in the business of saving. He's in the business of reconciling men to himself. That's what this thing is all about. Yes. Jesus wants to save your enemy, not kill your enemy. You know why they wanted to kill Lazarus? It was in the text. They wanted to kill Lazarus because of his testimony. Yeah, because of his testimony. See, what was going on is that people were coming to Christ because of Lazarus. And my friends, it's not going to be until you start praying for your enemies that people start coming to Christ. Nobody wants to hear it. I know you don't hear it. That's okay. It's okay. I see you playing with that baby, trying to play like you don't hear what I'm saying. I see some of y'all trying to talk to each other and all that kind of stuff. I see you looking down right now. But let me tell you something. I'm talking to you. I'm talking about your enemy. And I'm telling you that Jesus loves your enemy. And you need to love your enemy. And you need to pray for your enemy. Because once you do that, you don't know, you are the very person that can bring them to Christ.
You say, wait a minute, Pastor. I don't, this is a bit too much for me. After I preached this morning, a woman was at the altar. We give the benediction, and one of my sisters was at the altar crying, saying, Pastor, it's too much for me. I can't do it. I heard you preaching what you said. It is too much for me. I can't. The person's done me too wrong. Person hurt me too bad. It's just too much for me. I'm sorry. I can't do it. I can't do it. I can't do it. Can't do it. I hear you. I'm listening to you right now. I hear your heart. I can sense what you are saying to me. I can sense what you're struggling with right now. I can sense what you're saying to God. You're saying it the same way. You're not at the altar. But you're saying, that you don't know what this Negro did to me. You don't know how this person broke my heart, took my heart out, threw it on the ground, and spit on it and stepped on it. I know you don't mean me pray for that person. I just told you, my friends, that Jesus rode into Jerusalem. And the greatest thing about this story, my friends, is that Jesus knew that that same mob was going to lift up their voices 1 week later and say, not Hosanna, but they were going to say, crucify him. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? Same people, same people, same people, same people. His enemies, the ones who wanted to destroy him, but how he dealt with his enemy was that he went not to Jerusalem, not just to Jerusalem. The way you deal with your enemy is you got to go to Calvary. I'm sorry, you, but that's what you got to do in here today. The only way you can deal with what that person has done to you is you got to allow yourself to be crucified. Paul says, I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, yet not I, but Christ that dwelleth in me. You got to die. You're not dead enough. Are you hearing what I'm saying? You got to die. You're not dead enough, because if you were dead enough, you wouldn't have the feelings that you have. You got to die in Christ. Again, you got to go to Calvary. You got to take the example of the Lord Jesus Christ himself. The Bible makes it very clear that he knew what was going on. And that Jesus knew that he was going to his death. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Jesus knew that many of the people that were waving palm branches and singing Hosanna in the highest, he knew that those same people would turn their backs on him. Am I right about it? So you need to take a cue from Jesus. Here's what he did. He went on to Calvary. Yes, and aren't you glad that he went on to Calvary? I'm asking you a question. Aren't you glad that he went on to Calvary? Aren't you glad that he went on to Calvary? Aren't you glad that he went on to Calvary? Aren't you glad that he's not in Jerusalem somewhere sitting on the throne? Aren't you glad about that? He bypassed a temporary throne and he went to Calvary, and you know what happened, don't you? Don't you know what happened? They took him and they hung him on the cross, and they lifted him high and they stretched him wide. Am I right about it? Can I get a witness here? I'm sorry, but I got the clothes on Jesus, and I got a clothes on the cross. Yeah, because everything else I've said is a sideshow to what he did. I wish somebody could tell me what he did there. I wish somebody would tell me what he did there. Yeah, say it again. Say it again. I ought to have a deacon out there that can say, he died. Yes, he died. But before he died, I heard him say, Father, 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 forgive them. Are you hearing what I'm saying? He went to the Calvary. He went to the cross. They stretched him wide. They hung him low. And he said, forgive them. Forgive them. Forgive them. For they know not what they do. Yeah. You got to get to the point that you understand your enemy is ignorance.
Your enemy has lack of knowledge. Your enemy does not know who they're messing with. Your enemy don't know that they're messing with a child of God. Your enemy don't know that you are their deliverance. Your enemy don't know that. And that's why you got to be high enough to say, Father, Father, forgive them, forgive them, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Can I get a witness here? Can I get a witness here?